It took me several years to research and develop the concepts and sort out production methods. And for the last 3 years, we are on the market with our small company, Schwung Guitars, making the best possible guitar for a fair price. I apologize for making some advertisements here. That's inevitable when talking about my ideas on quality. So what contributes to excellent playability and tone and intonation and tuning stability? Well, it obviously starts with a good design. And with that, I don't mean aesthetics. Well, that too, but I focus first and primarily on construction and ergonomics. A good guitar should play like driving a Ferrari, which can be accomplished by means of a compound radius fingerboard, the right kind of frets, a nice feel of the neck, low string action, well-reachable highest frets. The guitar should have a good balance, both hanging on a strap and sitting on your lap. It must stay in tune, extremely important. And all knobs, tuning pegs and jack input should be easily accessible. Furthermore, the guitar must be constructed in such a way that string energy is transferred to the whole guitar as much as possible. In guitar lingo, this is referred to as coupling. The entire electric guitar must resonate acoustically, because, as you may know, tone is not just determined by the electronics, but equally by wood and hardware. Also, I believe the intonation must be perfect, or I should say optimal, not only because nothing is perfect, but because intonation is always a compromise because of differences between strings in thickness, length, and action on the frets. Furthermore, it's fine if an electric guitar has a number of sound options in the way of electronics, but please not too many. Well, this is all very nice, but playing comfort is still mostly determined by the neck. I made it medium chunky and slightly asymmetrical, like Stevie Ray Vaughan used to prefer. That is, the bottom is somewhat slimmer than the thumb side. Give it a try someday. We offer others custom options for neck shape as well, because I know it's a very personal matter. The 24 frets are made of stainless steel. I use Ferdinand Wagner only, Edelstahl, made in Germany, small, medium or jumbo. Durable and hard, resulting in good coupling, meaning better tone and sustain. Fret leveling is of utmost importance. We all want low action, string action, without too much buzz. Well, there is a company in Berlin since some years that is capable of very precise laser and computer controlled fret leveling. The 4-2 positioning of the tuners means there is space for your fingers. The strings run dead straight across the nut, and string length beyond the nut is neither too long nor too short. The G string is the longest, which enhances elasticity, which helps for bendings. I believe the 4-2 is the best possible positioning of the tuners. The Sperzer locking tuners are staggered, meaning the further away from the nut, the lower they are. This results in ideal string angles and pressure on the nut, eliminating the need for string retainers. The nut itself is coming from GrafTech, rock hard and self-lubricating, and without the inconsistencies you sometimes find in bone. All this has a significant positive effect on tuning stability. For more, check out our YouTube channel and website, and follow us on social media. Thanks for watching. Cheers.